Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we are going to see about what is the AVERAGEX function in DAX. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin our today's topic. So we have a scenario here. Let me explain the data. I have very simple data set over here. I have something like forecast. And the forecast, we have a forecast value and the actual for each month. Okay, so you can add other attributes. In typical business scenario, you will not get only simple data like this. You will also have for which category you will get this forecast and for different period. That is fine. I've taken a simple example that is for 2021 to 2022 fiscal year. So we have forecast value of 2000 each month, and this is the actual value. So when we are going to apply AVERAGEX, let me try to explain some scenarios, and we will stuck somewhere to get the average value. Then we will go for to solve that problem. We will use the AVERAGEX function. So let me walk you through the problem. Now we have a forecast and actual value. Usually people use it to, once you see the data over here in the charts over here in the forecast and actual, this gives something rough figure, because each month the forecast exactly you cannot meet the forecast. Sometimes you can see it is below your forecast value, and some months it is above your forecast value. The forecast is 2000, this month forecast exceeded, this month forecast is 2000 and actual is 1900. So it is always fluctuating. This doesn't give us a very quick insight what is happening at the overall picture. So usually what people used to do is like analyzing the accuracy of your forecast. Whatever you forecast, you do, how accurate it is, right? For that, the measure how you can calculate the accuracy, okay, that is what we want to see. So basically, I have a formula here, that is forecast minus actual, then divide it by the actual again. So you can see the formula again, forecast minus actual and divide by. The divide function takes the first parameter, numerator, and the denominator is again the actual. And sometimes, as I said, it will become positive or negative. That doesn't matter. We want to find how much percentage different, whether it's above or below. So I put absolute. This is how usually people calculate the accuracy formulas. So this is the actual difference between forecast and actual. Okay, this is the percentage difference. What do you mean by accuracy? You compare it with 100, I mean 100 percentage. From 100 percentage accurate, how much it is deviated? So it is 98.9% accurate. So this particular quarter, like that, right? That is how we will calculate. Now you see the accuracy formula, which is nothing but 1 minus percentage difference, okay? If it is blank, I make it as blank because other members, other periods also you will get a data. So that is what this condition is. So accuracy is over here. So accurate, you see here 3.63% deviated on April, which is 96.3%. This is your accuracy. So everything is fine here. Whatever you see monthly, how much accurate your forecast values. So this is how people used to compare the forecast and actual using the accuracy. But the problem comes here, like on month, I need to see the difference. But when it comes to quarterly, what should happen? I need average of these months. So how this accuracy is calculated, you can see from the formula, 1 minus percentage difference. So this calculating at the total level, at the quarter level. So this 98.90, which is nothing but 6000 minus 5935 divided by 5935, which is 1.10%. From 100, when we subtract, it will give you 98.90%. But people don't want this. Instead, I want average of each month. So 96.37, 98.77, 98.99 divided by 3. How I should calculate. So this is where problem comes. The simple accuracy formula won't work for you. So how to overcome this problem? I use the AVERAGEX. If you see the formula I used, just calculate the accuracy formula, the same accuracy formula. But what I will do, AVERAGEX of values of forecast month, that month. Okay. This I already explained when to use the dot month, dot date. When you are using hierarchy without a date dimension, you will use this one. When you are not using the hierarchy, then you can ignore this dot. Now I am using the hierarchy, I will use it. So what it will do, AVERAGEX takes the table. My table is values of month. So at this level, I need to do the average. So basically assume like something like group by of month, and you will have each month value. On top of that, you will do the average X, meaning like you have 12 months data, 3 months data, it is your quarter. So for that quarter level, it will do the average. So average X of what values you see, what values at what level you have to aggregate and divide, you need to use that value here. Now you see the average accuracy value here. At month level, it remains same because average X of month you put, and at the month level, it the value accuracy divided by 1. For this also 1, but when it comes to quarter, when you do the average X, it will sum up all the 3 months data. So 3 months data, then divide by 3. So it is the actual expected value. In order to show it to you, let's take a Calci here and try to sum it up. 98.99 plus 98.77 plus 96.37 equals divided by 3, which is 98.04. That is what we got. So you understand now, instead of all this accuracy formula, you can use only this average accuracy formula using AVERAGEX. Ensure that you use the at what level you want this to be aggregated and divided. So that particular column you need to use here. I hope you understand when to use AVERAGEX in your business scenarios. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. And do remember that data is your asset.